That is a AK-47 bayonet knife. I'm showing this because if you guys have a knife that you need a sheath for, all you got to do is send it in. This guy mailed it in to me, and we made a nice sheath for it. Okay. Came out really nice. It matches the whole theme of the AK with the Coyote Brown or FDE, whatever you want to call it. We use Coyote Brown. I call it FDE. It's a shade darker. I think it looks better than FDE. On the site, we call it FDE. To me, it's FDE. It's very similar. So, you can see how nice that came out. And what's cool about this knife is there's a hole in the middle of it, so it actually creates its own little retention when the knife slides in. You know, it just happens to have that. It was pretty neat. So that was a help, actually, making this. So if my man's seeing this video, there's your sheath for your AK bayonet. Came out really nice. The fit's great. I'm very, very happy with the fit. I'm very fussy with the fit because that's the biggest thing to master with this, doing this Kydex stuff, and it just takes long to get good at it. You know what I'm saying? Even if you have the best molds, it's still, you know, you got to get a feel for it. And I think that one has a great fit. And this is one I just want to show you because now we're doing on every outside the waistband holster. This is a Glock 19 with a TLR 7. Now what I do is I use the TLR 8 mold because all the TLR 8 is has a little hump on the bottom for a laser, but everything else is exactly the same shape of the light. So the TLR 8 mold will fit the TLR 7 mold. So that's what's great. So I can do the TLR 8 or the TLR 7. There's your adjustment for the tension. And you got to remember the light holsters. When you slide them in, there's no like superior click or clunk, or they kind of just glide in and out of the holster. But this helps you squeeze a little bit, I guess around the base of the light. That'll squeeze it just a little bit, just to give it a little bit more retention. But you're not going to get that click. So I hope if you know, you guys that know guns know that that's just how light bearing holsters are. But it does have a really nice fit, this particular one. I'm really happy with it. So it's a Glock 19, TLR 8, TLR 7, and the A version of the TLR 7. I heard, someone sent me a video, that it, even though the switch is in a different spot, it still fits. Okay? This particular gentleman ordered this and a SIG P20, I can never say the damn thing. Oh shit, I brought it inside. Sorry, can't even show you the holster. It's a SIG P2022, and I think he's going to put the TLR 7A on it. But before we did it, we both did a little research and made sure it would fit, and they say it will. We'll see when he gets it. So that's it. Nothing else really going on right now. Just giving you updates. And I'll talk to you guys.